Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today. Now I would like to discuss about the discharges, different discharges of nipple. Okay, what are the different types of discharges which are present in the nipple? Discharges from the nipple, I'm sorry, it's not off, it's from the nipple. So, this is the nipple. So, these are the ducts. So, sometimes there are some discharges which are emitting from either one of the lactiferous ducts or many lactiferous ducts. Okay, so there are different types. There are different differential diagnoses based on the type of the discharge. So I'll just show you that from my notebook itself so that it becomes easier instead of writing it again. So the discharges can be clear or serous, or they can be blood stained, or they can be black or green coloration, discoloration, discharge. So, if there is clear discharge or serous discharge, then it can be due to physiological, or it can be due to ductal papilloma or mammary dysplasia. Clear or serous discharge, it is seen if it is due to physiological, it can be due to physiological or ductal papilloma or mammary dysplasia. The discharge can be bloodstained. Bloodstained discharge is seen in ductal ectasia, ductal papilloma, and ductal carcinoma. Then there is black or green color discharge, which is seen in ductal ectasia and its complications. So these are based on the color of the discharge. It's important for you to remember. And then discharge based on the different, where is it from coming from? Is it coming from the surface? Is it coming from the duct? Or is it coming from the one duct or all the ducts? More than one ducts. So, the discharge, if it is coming from the surface of the skin, then that is Paget's disease. That can be due to Paget's disease, skin disease like eczema, psoriasis. Rarely, it can be chancre. If it is coming from the single duct, then it can be bloodstained or serous. If it is bloodstained, it can be intraductal papilloma or intraductal carcinoma. It can also be due to duct ectasia. It can also cause serous discharge. If it is a serous discharge, it can cause fibrocystic disease or ductal ectasia or ductal carcinoma. If it is a serous discharge, it can be due to fibrocystic disease or ductal ectasia or ductal carcinoma. And then, if it is coming from more than one duct, even now you can divide it into the color, whether it is bloodstained or black or green or purulent or in serous. If it is bloodstained, it can be from carcinoma, ectasia, fibrocystic disease. If it is black or green, it can be due to duct ectasia. If it is purulent infection, purulent discharge, it can be due to infection. If it is a serous discharge, it can be due to fibrocystic disease. So these are the different diseases and the discharges which you see. It's important to remember them, but anyways, I don't know, it depends upon the person and your college issues. Okay. Now, how are you going to treat these discharges? There are many. First and foremost, exclude carcinoma, because there is a chance of carcinoma by cytology. So always exclude carcinoma with the help of histological features or with the help of cytology. Okay. Then you can do some surgeries. There are two different surgeries which are available. Okay. The first type is called as microdotectomy. Microdotectomy. This is one word. I just wrote it differently so that you can read it easily. So this is microdotectomy. Here, if this is the nipple, now in microdotectomy, first we make a periareolar incision. The incision that we use is periareolar, that is around the areola. Okay, and then we will just dissect this nipple flap. We will dissect this nipple flap is taken like this. And then, what do we do? And then, what we are doing is, we will just introduce the things into the nipple. Okay? And we will excise one duct. This duct is excised now. So, once we excise this duct, how does this look? Just a minute, I'll draw a little bigger diagram. Once the duct is excised, this is the excised duct. And these are the other ducts. See, it is mostly done if there is single, if the discharge is from only one duct. So if you see, if the discharge is from single duct, then you can do this surgery, which is called as microdotectomy, where the duct is excised. Here, duct is excised. And if you see the duct is excised, then it is like this, okay? Even if you can excise two ducts or you can excise three or more ducts, okay? Depending upon the need, you can do that. And then after excising the ducts, you can do a ductoscopy to visualize the other ducts also, to visualize the other ducts. So that is microdochectomy, that is one of the surgery. The other surgery is cone excision of major duct. Here, this cone excision of the major duct, this is mainly for if there is discharge from multiple ducts. If there is discharge from multiple ducts are excised at the same time. At the same time, you can excise multiple ducts. So what are we doing here? Even here, we give an incision, which is periareolar incision. Okay, and then after giving the periareolar incision, see, this is the one. Okay, so here you'll have ducts. Okay, you'll give a periareolar incision and excise the entire duct system. Now what you do is you'll excise the entire duct system in the form of a cone. See, you have formed a cone and you are excising the entire duct system to the base of the pectoral fascia. Here you'll have pectoral fascia and here you'll have muscle, right? Just till the pectoral fascia, you'll excise all the duct tissue. So that is taken out as a form of cone, okay? And then you will put a temporary suction to see if there is any discharge. After doing this, you'll just put a temporary suction. After doing this, you'll put a temporary suction for obliterating the, draining all the discharges. Okay, so you are excising the all the ducts in the form of cone. Okay, so this is cone excision of major ducts, or there is also a name for it that is called as Hadfield cone excision. Hadfield cone excision. Okay, so this is about the discharges from the duct. So I think you guys have understood about the discharges from the duct. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.